My name is Pixelated Twix, and welcome to another episode of Coffee Talk. Now, it's been a long time since I have been doing a Coffee Talk. Since the last time I did a Coffee Talk, I should say. But I really wanted to do one because let me put this down because this is going to make a lot of noise, a lot of clink, 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 clinks. But I wanted to do a Coffee Talk because I've been playing Dragon Age Origins, and one of the last episodes I recorded, I came across Alistair, my Grey Warden's possible love interest. Oh, let's just face it, love interest. And he had asked if we could go find his sister in Denerim. Now, this was someone that he had never met and had not actually known existed, but had some information, some type of intel that she did, and he wanted to find her. So indeed, my Grey Warden agreed to help him find her in Denerim. And it was an easy quest, really. We just kind of walked into Denerim, and he had her address, and so we approached the house. Now, when I first did this quest, I admit that my initial reaction to Goldanna and my choice and the reason for my choices were kind of brash and maybe not well thought out. But after I kind of mulled over this idea in my head, I think I have a different outlook on Goldanna wholeheartedly, or just in general. And most of it is just from life's experiences, my own life experiences, maybe my religious beliefs possibly would have something to do with my thoughts later after I mulled over this quest. And it's very odd because I normally don't think about things like this, but this one really kind of latched onto me, so I just wanted to discuss it a little bit. I don't know if you're even interested, but I thought maybe it'd be a cool little conversation to have with you. And if you have some thoughts, if you have played Dragon Age Origins and maybe you have your own opinions about Goldanna and maybe have a little more information on the lore and on her, let me know in the comments because I really want to know. This would be, I think, a good conversation to have. So as I said, Goldanna, when you arrive at Goldanna's house, she approaches, she thinks that you're a customer and that you need to do laundry. And so she comes out and says, oh, here's the laundry, this is the prices, and don't trust Natalia. She's foreign and she'll, you know, charge her arm and a leg for the laundry.
Hello?
Hey, you have linens to wash? I charge 3 bits on a bundle, you won't find better. And don't trust what that Natalia woman tells you either. She's foreign and she'll rob you blind.
And I thought that was kind of hilarious since my Grey Warden's name is Natalia. Wasn't planned. So the encounter wasn't great. We had a back and forth with Goldanna. She was highly upset that she found out that Alistair was still alive, that she had been told that he was dead, and that was she was to even hide that he even existed in the first place. And I assume that maybe she was paid off. I don't know. She was told to hold the secret that he had even been alive. And then she was told that he was dead. And Alistair said, no, I am that baby. I'm your brother. And her, instead of reacting in a way where she would celebrate that he was indeed alive and that she had, you know, some of her family back in her life, she goes onto this diatribe of blaming him for her life.
The babe didn't die. I'm him. I'm your brother.
For all the good it does me. You killed mother, you did. And I've had to scrape by all this time. That coin didn't last long. And when I went back, they ran me off.
So is she everything you expected, Alistair? I don't think this was a good idea. This is hardly Alistair's fault. Blaming him that her life didn't turn out the way that she wanted, that she initially thought, that blamed him for the death of her mother. She had a lot of thoughts about Alistair, a lot of assumptions. She had no idea. She didn't know anything about Alistair's life, what he had been through, but she just assumed from what she thought she knew about him. So I think when I went back and looked at this quest in my head, I just want to share a few things. So I believe Natalia did hold a grudge against Alistair, finding out one that he was alive, and so she unloaded on him. Basically, I think she had all this pent up anger over the years, for one, because she had to hide his existence, and that she'd been lied to. So everything that she thought was her reality, and maybe she thought, well, all this time he's been alive, I could have been getting something out of this, right? And so, because she did mention that she should have said something, she should have opened her mouth. But again, she thought he was dead. And so she was holding on to this bitter, these bitter feelings about even his existence, that her mother was dead because of him, even though I think she died in birth. That's what Alistair was told. And so she had all these thoughts about him, that he was privileged, and she prejudged him. She alluded to the thought that he was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. And she even said, I quote, "Ooh, I see, a prince and a Grey Warden too. Well, who am I to think poorly of someone so high and mighty compared to me?" So she probably already had some preconceived notions about what royalty was. Obviously, classism was a thing. Classism still is a thing. We have our elitist people, and then we have middle class and poor. And as the world goes on, poor and middle class have become closer and closer together, and the elites have gotten richer and richer. So there's still, though, this thought about class, and it's more or less about class and culture, right? And so that most likely and did exist in this world as well. That class, culture, even race, was indicative of where you stood in line. Also, not just that, but if you're a mage, you were thought of even less. So she was probably at the low end of the totem pole. The woman had 5 children. Okay, she was single. She didn't have a husband. And in those days, maybe even now, but single people were thought of less than you were, especially women. Women were basically valued according to if they were married or not, right? Their husband determined their initial value. And so Goldanna, and I'm just relating this to the real world here. I don't know if that exactly existed then, but looking at it in the perspective of, I forgot, the queen, Kaelin's wife, and how her father took over the throne and didn't even get bat an eye at it. Like, she would have been, I would assume that if they had no heir, that which they didn't, Goldanna would have been the reigning queen. But her dad took over. He just took over, no royal blood whatsoever. And whatever she thought, whatever her opinions were, he was not even taking them into consideration. Her feelings about, he even killed her husband, got her husband killed, and had no regard for her feelings. So I, taking that information, and I assume that Goldanna was probably valued even less because she didn't have a husband. She had 5 children. I don't really know the family dynamic there with her and her children, if there was a father or multiple fathers, if the father passed, or if he left and left her on the lurch with 5 children. Either way, there was a huge struggle for Goldanna. And so, again, there was that hate towards Alistair, because you left me here, how she looked at it. Oh, you show up at my front door now. How long did you know I exist? Maybe I have 5 children. You're the king's son, and you probably have money. You're a Grey Warden, all this stuff, right? It's not. What?
And who in the Maker's name are you? Some tart following after his riches, I expect.
Hey, don't speak to her that way. She's my friend and a Grey Warden, just like me.
Oh, I see. A prince and a Grey Warden too. Well, who am I to think poorly of someone so high and mighty compared to me? I don't know you, boy. Your royal father forced himself on my mother and took her away from me. And what do I got to show for it? Nothing. They tricked me good. I should have told everyone. I got 5 mouths to feed. And unless you can help with that, I got less than no use for you.
Her modus operandi was money. And I don't even know if it really was about her children. I think it was more or less about her, because she mentioned her children multiple times that, oh, I've got 5 children, but she didn't say that they need things. It was more or less about her. It was really just about her. I think she used her children as a way to eat away at Alistair's soft heart, because Alistair, obviously, and most people, right, would have a bleeding heart towards children. If children are getting hurt, a lot of people would respond to a situation differently than if it was just maybe an adult. You know how it is. A puppy, a child, bleeding hurts. And so that's one thing I will say, side note, that really irks me when people use their children as pawns. That really irks me. Anyways, so I really thought about Goldanna and, her, like I said, her initial reaction to Alistair. And as we went into the conversation, I chose to, she asked for money, Alistair. So I guess we could give her some money for the children, again, catering to or his bleeding heart. So I initially said, oh, I really don't want to give her any money. But I thought, yes, no, I'll give her money for Alistair. But like I said, as I mulled this over, really my reason should have been for the children and would have really been for the children had I really thought through that quest like I should have. It would have been for the children. That would have been my only reason. Well, my first reason, and then Alistair, or my Grey Warden's love for Alistair, or growing love for Alistair, because she did have a connection with him. Meanwhile, okay, Alistair was probably feeling really rejected, as he didn't have a true family, and all he wanted to do was find a sense of belonging, which is why he was so excited about finding Goldanna. This was his connection, finally. He lived his life as a bastard. He knew that he was the son of a king, but it had been hidden. And then had been sent to the chantry to live amongst the cloistered sisters by his uncle, Arl Eamon's wife, because she didn't like him. She didn't want him in the house. And it makes me wonder why initially, well, I suppose I understand why they hid him in secret, why they made his life, that his existence secretive. I guess Alistair's existence alone would be a threat to Caelan's claim to the throne. I don't know if Caelan was older or younger. If he was younger, Alistair would have definitely been a threat. Even still, Alistair would have, since King Caelan was dead or is dead, he would have a claim to the throne. And now he definitely is a threat to Loghain. But so that's neither here nor there. There was a little side thing, but really I think Alistair, as a Grey Warden, he had a reason to fight, right, the darkspawn, this blight. But I think that his thought process of, I'm a Grey Warden, I have to save the world, became null and void when he found out that he had a real family, like his sister existed. I think now it became bigger than just saving the world. I think perhaps it was the idea of saving his own little world, his own family, a possibility of having his own family and saving his family. And Goldanna just completely rejected him again, which is why I hated how I responded to even that. My initial response was, hey, let's go, there's nothing here for you, where there was another choice of, you don't need her, you have us, we're your family now. And I think Natalia would have said that. She would have said, we're your family now. I'm your family. She's been with him now for probably months on the road. And there would have been a huge connection, especially with the fact that Natalia had lost her own family in such a violent way, and she would have wanted to find family with Alistair because, you know, of their connection in this tumultuous time. Even the other ragtag parts of the party would have been Natalia's family. So, as I said, we left the house with this real sense of sadness. Alistair was probably mourning, again, the loss of his family, and Natalia mourning with him. So my response was wrong, and I wish I could go back and change it. But anyways, I just wanted to throw those thoughts out to you guys. I don't know if you remember that quest, and I'll try to pop the clip in somewhere for you to take a look at. Maybe I'll throw some clips in here and there so you can kind of refresh your memory about the quest. But let me know if you have seen that quest, played Dragon Age, seen that quest, you remember that quest. What was your thought about Goldanna? Have you ever really thought about it? How did you respond to Goldanna? I guess that would really depend on how you played your Grey Warden, because you can play your Grey Warden as evil, whereas I'm playing my Grey Warden as inherently good. And so, yeah. Also, if we know anything further about Goldanna, if we see her later, I know there were hints of her, in the Darkspawn Chronicles, I think. And I'm wondering if she did survive the blight at all. It didn't seem like Denerim, I don't remember. Did Denerim get hit? I don't know. I don't remember where we end up. It's been so long, really. But I'm wondering if she even survived the blight, and if she did, what her life turned out to be. Because there is no further mention of her. So yeah. Anyways, those are my thoughts. I hope you enjoyed, you know, my initial thoughts, and maybe I can get your opinion on my thoughts and what you experienced and what you were thinking when you went through that quest, if anything. All right, so this has been Coffee Talk. I'll see you later. Ciao.